A long time ago, in a galaxy far, far away. Star Wars, Rise of the Inquisitor. Dark times have fallen upon the galaxy. The Old Republic and their stalwart Jedi protectors has since fallen 12 years ago. In its place, the Galactic Empire, ruled by Emperor Palpatine and Darth Vader, holds the galaxy in an iron grip. Meanwhile, tiny sparks of rebellion rise across the galaxy, and the Empire's legions of stormtroopers are unleashed across rebel-infested worlds to snuff out any dissent. Though the rebels prove valiant fighters, they still lack unity. Aboard the Imperial Star Destroyer, Imperator, a talented and respected admiral named Ryko Vasari commands his fleet to intercept a rebel cruiser that is escaping an Imperial-controlled world. Unbeknownst to the admiral, his destiny will be changed forever. Chapter 1. Admiral Vasari, sir. We've come across a Nebulon B frigate. Shall we open fire? Imperial Lieutenant Victor Stahl, blonde-haired and blue-eyed, asked his superior commander. He wore a standard black officer uniform and stood straight, awaiting Vasari's orders. The 30-year-old Admiral, Ryko Vasari, who stood looking out of the viewport of the Star Destroyer Imperator, wore his admiral's cap atop his black-haired head. And his uniform was very well kept, and he possessed a thin black beard. Despite his looks, he wasn't your typical by-the-book Imperial officer, and rather used very intricate and unorthodox tactics to win a battle. No, Lieutenant. Tell the rest of the fleet to box them in, and inform Captain Ramius to activate his interdiction field so that we can board the ship and steal any intel aboard, he ordered. Yes, sir. I'll inform Captain Ramius immediately, Stahl acknowledged. Excellent, Vasari said, looking out towards the rebel ship and stroking his beard. A few minutes passed by, and Captain Ramius appeared in a hologram on the bridge deck. This is Captain Ramius. That Nebulon B frigate won't be going anywhere, Ramius stated. Good, our first catch of the day. Prepare the boarding shuttles once the Imperator activates the tractor beam. Vasari commanded, self-assured that he will impress Grand Moff Tarkin with rebel intel. Admiral, we have enemy ships coming up from behind the asteroid belt. They must have hid there and used the frigate as a decoy. Stahl panicked. Damn those filthy rebel scum! Inform all other Star Destroyers in the fleet to engage the other cruisers. I want this Nebulon B boarded and probed for intel by any means necessary, Vasari demanded. Admiral Vasari was known, throughout the 62nd Imperial Fleet that he commanded, to possess an unnatural and somewhat extraordinary ability to keep himself calm and collected during situations that would otherwise make any other admiral be demoralized or daunted. At the same time, this strange phenomenon also oddly enough kept his own crew members calm as well, often turning the tide of battle. Lo and behold, the main bulk of the Star Destroyers mopped up the rebel ambushes with ease, and the Imperial boarding party successfully entered the Nebulon B frigate, killing almost everyone aboard. However, there was still one life form aboard, one that Vasari himself wanted to interrogate. So he had the prisoner be transferred aboard the Imperator, and to his surprise, the captive was none other than a Jedi, however just a former Padawan that still had connection to the Force. As he was taken in handcuffs to the bridge, clad in his Jedi robes, the Jedi said something odd about the Admiral standing before him. What are the odds? I see a rebel ship fleeing the system, and to my surprise, I've acquired myself a hefty prize while boarding it. Tell me, Jedi, what is your name? Vasari asked him. The hell does it matter to you? I'm only going to be killed anyway, right? The Jedi replied. No, my dear friend, we have other plans. Perhaps we can take you to Mustafar, Vasari suggested, knowing Mustafar was a planet where Jedi are ruthlessly interrogated and even killed. I'd rather die. But before I do, I want to let you know something. I noticed that your men seem to have some damn good morale. When I entered your bridge, it's as if I could feel your power among these men. Is it possible that you're Force-sensitive? The Jedi pondered, still handcuffed while flanked by stormtroopers brandishing their E-11 blaster rifles. Force-sensitive? I highly doubt it. Unless you could elaborate on your theory. Vasari wondered if he was actually right, and it made him wonder how the Empire would handle such a thing. You ever hear of battle meditation? It's a force power that can sway entire legions to have their morale boosted, while the enemy's morale drops. Only a handful of people can do it. It's just a shame an Imperial bootlicker like you probably has such an ability, the Jedi explained. Growing impatient, Vasari turned to Stahl. Lieutenant, put our new prisoner in cell block 1917, and have the 62nd Fleet set course for the Mustafar system, Vasari decreed. Yes, sir, but what about the Nebulon B? Stahl asked. Extract every scrap of data on that ship, and then destroy it along with the rest of the Rebel fleet that lay in ruin, Vasari demanded. Yes, sir, Stahl acknowledged. As the Nebulon B frigate drifted away from the Star Destroyers and exploded from being bombarded by volleys of green turbolaser fire, they turned towards the Mustafar system and entered hyperspace.